Welcome to Talking Trash, and today we're going to be talking about waste reduction. So that's reducing the amount of waste that we make. And there are many programs that are out there and available, but I just want to tell you of a few. So now, what we used to call this was a waste audit. Audit is kind of a scary word for most people, and especially for businesses. I like to call it a waste survey. So you're basically just taking a peek at what you produce in your place of business and how can you deal with it differently. And so how many people, just a question, if you have a business, do you look at what you throw, what you buy, how you buy it, how you throw it? Because there's lots of options. So one acronym that comes across that I've seen a lot lately, it's called WRAP. Now I like that because it's nice and quick and it kind of gets your attention, but it means waste reduction action plan. So it's basically just putting some thought into what kind of waste you have. And I just want to tell you up front, I know of a business in town in Detroit Lakes that actually happened to look at their waste. They looked at their dumpster, they looked at where their garbage cans are and where their recycling bins were. And just by moving things around and looking at their waste and surveying that, they save themselves $10,000 a year. So it's possible. It's just kind of taking an inventory of what you're doing and how you're doing it. And so just a few things that you can do with a WRAP or a waste reduction action plan. First, you have to make the commitment. You have to make the commitment to do something about your waste, whether it's reduce it or buying differently, whatever. If you reduce your waste, what happens? Generally, you save costs. It's not just at the disposal end of it, but at the purchasing end, you can buy in bulk. And we at the county buy in bulk. We buy cleaners, but we buy them in bulk and we add the water so that you don't have to pay for the water transport. Then, so you, the first thing, make a commitment. Then you want to assemble a team, get people that are invested in recycling or in reducing waste. That might be an auditor or a financial person in your facility. For sure, maintenance. Maintenance is key. Someone that's interested and works with the waste in your facility. You want to look at an audit. So whether that is emptying your garbage cans, doing a little mini garbage sort, where you put out a tarp and you dump your garbage and you kind of see what's in your waste. You know, how many people do you look in your garbage can very often? I do, but I'm not the normal person. So you want to make it easy. Actually, you want to develop a plan. How can we do it? What we buy? How do you deal with it? What can we recycle? What can we maybe compost? And then throwing it away, the last resort. You want to make it really easy, really easy. And so it's something very understandable, easy signage, easy process so that employees don't get confused or that kind of thing. And maybe have some trainings. It's pretty easy. It doesn't have to be long and intensive, but it's pretty easy, or it should be pretty easy. Then you launch your program. You monitor the progress by weighing maybe how much you're reducing, or by volume, by yardage. Kind of just you're documenting the progress basically, and then publicize. Let your employees know they're doing a great job, they're reducing waste. And then if they're saving you money, let them know. That's a great thing to do. And then buying recycled content. So for example, at the courthouse, toilet paper. We have two kinds of toilet paper. We have big rolls and little rolls. They're both recycled content. Really simple. Our paper towels behind me are recycled content. Really simple. And that is closing the loop. If you recycle and then you purchase recycling, then it works. That triangle of recycling that you see on lots of products, so the little tiny recycling symbol there, that tells us that it's a recycled content. And you're closing the loop. You're making recycling work because you bought it and you do it. So great job. And if you'd like to recycle in your business, please give our office a call, Becker County Environmental Services, and we'd love to help you if that's something you're interested in. We'd come in and help do a waste survey for you or a waste audit. help you kind of think through what you buy, what you purchase, what you throw. Placement is really important, where you put your recycling bins, where you put your garbage bins, that kind of thing. We'll help you kind of think through that. And then there's also lots of things available. You can contact your hauler. They have containers available. You can contact us, Becker County Environmental Services. We'd love to share what we have in our program. We have recycling dumpsters that are available for lease. We also have the blue curbside carts that are available. And so we can work with you through that to help you save money. And the goal is for us is to reduce waste. Get that waste out of the waste stream. The less we're incinerating or landfilling, the better that we are as an environment, and for sure financially it helps everybody. So please give us a call, and then we have all kinds of suggestions of forms and all kinds of things. We'd be glad to help you out. So give us a call, 218-846-7310. Have a great day.